Jerry, you know that shoe repair place at the end of the block?
Well, if they don't
get some business, they're gonna have to shut down and make way for one of those gourmet coffee or cookie stores.
I like coffee.
I like cookies.
Yeah, of course you do. And you know why? Because you're a bunch of yuppies. No, it's your go-go corporate takeover lifestyles that are driving out these mom-and-pop stores and destroying the fabric of this neighborhood.
Well, what's so great about a mom-and-pop store? Let me tell you something. If my mom and pop ran a store, I wouldn't shop there.
Hey, Bogombo, they've been in the neighborhood for 48 years. Now, come on, Jerry. You got to have a pair of shoes in need of a cobbler.
I really don't wear the kind of shoes that have to be cobbled.
Well, what about sneakers? You know, they'll clean them. They do complete detailing.
All right, take them.
Yeah, yeah.
Kramer, without you, we'd be out of business.
Well, you know, these sneakers, they belong to my neighbor, Jerry Seinfeld, the comedian.
So many sneakers.
Well, he's got a Peter Pan complex.
They'll be ready a week from Thursday.
Oh, well, no rush. Uh-oh.
What's the matter?
I keep getting these nosebleeds.
Oh, lie down and put your head back.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Hey, what's with your ceiling?
What?
Well, you got wires sticking out every which way. That looks dangerous. You should call an electrician.
You know, in the 48 years we've been here, I don't think we've ever called an electrician.
Yeah, well, you should. This place could blow any minute.
Hey, where's all my sneakers?
You said take them.
Not all of them.
Well, obviously, there was a miscommunication.
Obviously. So what am I supposed to wear?
Jerry, I left you a pair right here.
Where?
Come on. Now, look it. Here. There, put on those.
I can't wear these.
Well, why not?
They're uncomfortable.
Come on, here. Try them on.
Oh.
Where did you get those?
I worked a club in Dallas one time, and they couldn't afford to pay me, so they gave me these. Oh, I can't wear these. They look ridiculous.
You look like a cowboy, huh?
I don't want to be a cowboy.
$4,000? We can't afford that.
Well, I'm afraid you're going to have to do something about it because it's in violation of the building code. Otherwise, they're going to close you up.
But suppose we can't pay for it?
Then I have to report you. Otherwise, I lose my license. Sorry.
48 years, Mom. And now we have to close. All because of that idiot and his bloody nose.
Afternoon, Mom. Afternoon, Pop. You know you got a crack in the sidewalk out there? Now you ought to get that fixed.
Hey, so where's my sneakers?
That's what I want to know.
What do you mean?
Well, I saw Mom and Pop this morning, but when I went by the store on my way home, the place was empty. Everything is gone. Mom and Pop vanished.
So all my sneakers are gone?
I'm afraid so, and that's just the tip of the iceberg. I've been asking around. They didn't even have any kids.
Mom and Pop aren't even a mom and pop?
It was all an act, Jerry. They conned us, and they scored big time.
So, Mom and Pop's plan was to move into the neighborhood, establish trust, for 48 years. And then run off with Jerry's sneakers.
Apparently.
Hello.
Hello, is this Jerry Seinfeld?
Yes, it is. You don't know me, but a really strange thing happened. I was at a garage sale, and this old couple sold me a used pair of sneakers they claim belonged to Jerry Seinfeld, the comedian.
Can I have the address of that garage sale?
Okay, thank you very much. I found Mom and Pop. They're selling my sneakers.
Where are they?
Parsippany, New Jersey.
Let's go.
My car's in the shop.
Well, how are we getting to Parsippany?
Oh. Jerry, these nosebleeds are starting again.
Maybe we should get you to a hospital.
Hey, I ain't going to no Bellevue. Look at me. I'm falling apart here.